Composed in 1897 by Paul Dukas, The Sorcerer's Apprentice is a symphonic poem based on Johann Wolfgang von Goethe's 1797 poem of the same name. In the poem, a young apprentice is left on his own to complete chores around the workshop. Looking for an easier way, the apprentice casts a spell on a nearby broom and enlists it into service cleaning the shop. Things quickly begin to spiral out of control as the broom pours buckets of water onto the floor, quickly flooding the shop. Just as the apprentice is accepting defeat, the sorcerer returns to his shop and quickly casts a spell to stop the brooms. In the original poem, the sorcerer is not angry at his young apprentice. Instead, he uses the blunder as an opportunity to teach his apprentice that the powerful spirits should only be called by those with enough mastery to control them. Since its inception, the story of The Sorcerer's Apprentice has been adapted to countless numbers of books, TV shows, cartoons, miniseries, stage productions, and movies. Dukas is probably the best example of a classical music one-hit wonder. In fact, during his lifetime, Dukas was probably better known in France as a critic rather than a composer, having several of his reviews published in numerous popular French art reviews. Though he had a total of about 15 published compositions, most of them paled in comparison to the popularity of Sorcerer's Apprentice. In a 1928 article in Musical Quarterly, Irving Schwerka remarked that Sorcerer's Apprentice not only surpassed all of Dukas' other works in popularity, but perhaps even overshadowed the original poem. Neither Dukas or Schwerka could foresee the impact that Disney's compilation of animated classical music shorts, Fantasia, would have on the piece. The glockenspiel part in Sorcerers is one of my all-time favorites, and a total workout for your hands and your head. While the two main sections that are commonly asked in auditions are rehearsals 17 to 20 and 22 to 24, the entire glock part presents an opportunity to explore different mallet options for sound, color, and character. Let's start by dissecting rehearsal 17. Dukas writes detaché, which is actually a bow marking indicating an aggressive staccato. Even though this technique is not possible on a glockenspiel, Dukas included the phrase as a stylistic marking, emphasizing the importance of a quick, staccato approach to this passage in order to match the rest of the ensemble. The next big thing that makes this spot difficult is the grace notes or slurs that Dukas has strategically placed on the downbeat of each bar. He also includes accents indicating that he really wants these to stand out in the texture. The trick with these is to not approach them like they are flams. Do not let your inner drummer take over here. Instead, you need to approach them as if you are a flute player connecting from the grace note to the primary note. The execution comes down to the amount of space and time you need to put in between the two notes. If you put too much space, it's going to sound like a different rhythm. And if you put too little space, it's going to sound like a flat flam. The last big decision you have to make in this excerpt is the 16th note run before rehearsal 19. Are you going to play it with straight sticking, or are you going to play it with doubles? Personally, I have always found the doubles to be easier and cleaner for me to play, and it almost always guarantees that I'm going to nail it on the first try. A great way to practice the doubles is to set up a practice pad next to your Glock and work on playing clean doubles with your Glock mallets, then transfer them over to the instrument. I know lots of people have different ways of playing this, so I'd be totally interested to hear in the comments whether you prefer to play it with straight sticking or if you use doubles. One last comment on this section, because it is just oozing with musical phrasing and shaping, which is one of the many reasons why I love this excerpt, because you can just analyze it to death. I can't forget to bring attention to the rinforzando on the downbeat of rehearsal 18. The literal definition for rinforzando is play with a sudden increase of force. For all intents and purposes, treat it like a stronger accent. You really want the A-flat to stick out in that bar. Let's move on now to the dreaded waterfall section of this piece. I don't know exactly where the term waterfall came from, but it is the nickname for the section that percussionists have been handing down to other percussionists for years. My best guess is that because the constant downward motion of the notes has a waterfall effect, perhaps Dukas intended for the part to represent the flowing water that plays such a large part in the Goethe poem. There is no doubt that this excerpt is extremely daunting if you are learning it for the first time. The good news is there are lots of different ways to work on it. But before we get into that, let's address the sticking. The best and most efficient way to approach this lick is with a double right hand sticking for each descending figure. So, the sticking you end up with for the most part is right, right, left, right, left. Here are the top three practice techniques I use to keep this excerpt in check. The first may seem obvious, but I think it is something we often neglect. Slow practice. I will regularly go half tempo on this to really check myself against the met and make sure that my rhythm and flow is solid. The second is to practice the sticking and rhythm on a practice pad like we did in the first section to really focus in on your time and consistency with the doubles. The last is to isolate what each hand is doing. To do this, put a soft rubber mallet in one hand and the mallet you are using for the excerpt in the other. This way you can clearly hear what each hand is doing and force yourself to focus in on just that hand. So there you have it. While this doesn't cover everything there is to know about sorcerers, hopefully this gets you off to a great start. These excerpts are some of the toughest and most time-consuming to learn, but with a lot of practice and the right approach, they can be conquered. If you have any other practice tips for sorcerers, we'd love to hear them, so please share them in the comments section below. The mallets you heard in today's episode are the Phoenix and Aerodonis, and you can grab your pair here at artifactpercussion.com. Thanks for watching, and until next time, happy practicing.